When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
If you're a fan of Broadway and humor and the movies, that song will make your heart beat a little faster. And not just because it's springtime, because it's springtime for Hitler. Written by Mel Brooks and put together almost inconceivably by Henry Mancini in a Latin Beat album from the late 1960s. Hello, this is Larry Mazlon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, here on 88.3 FM Connick Public Broadcasting, emanating from the blazing young anxiety hamlet of Southampton, New York. And I hope, listeners, you will be thrilled and delighted that we are going to spend an entire hour with movie maker, musical maven, meshugguner Mel Brooks and his particular brand of humor that filtered its way through the American musical. Not only, I guess, did the American musical influence Mel, but Mel, of course, has produced some of the biggest hits in the American musical. Our dear friend Mel was born Melvin Kaminsky 92 years ago, can you imagine? Worked his way through all sorts of avenues of showbiz. He tells a story in the documentary Broadway the American Musical, which I had a hand in, that his uncle was a taxi driver and brought him to see Anything Goes in the 1930s, and he sat all the way in the back row, and he could hear every syllable and note of Ethel Merman's. And at that moment, he said, I loved Broadway. I would do anything for Broadway. I would clean the toilets to be involved in a Broadway musical. And of course, he was. The first show he was ever involved with, around the time he was writing for Sid Caesar on Your Show of Shows, was New Faces of 1952. And he wrote some sketches for that show. Here is the opening number to New Faces of 1952, Mel Brooks's Broadway debut, sung by Ronnie Graham.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has certainly been a season for experimenting in the theater. The four-poster got the number of actors down to two. Emlyn Williams cut that in half. Cornelio de Skinner held the whole thing at par. I have only to leave this stage in order to break fresh ground. Even the production of Don Juan and Hell seemed to share in this passion for condensation. And so, building on the foundation they have laid, or rather removing what they have neglected to eliminate, we bring you what we consider to be the irreducible minimum. One obscure member of Actors' Equity reading a review. I shall now read new faces. First, the inevitable opening chorus. You've never seen us before. We've never seen you before. What a pleasant place to finally meet. Cast registers pleasure. So much pleasanter than a busy street. Cast does Times Square. We vocally take your hand and vocally shake your hand and ask you to regard this hullabaloo as I seem to have lost my place.
I'm sorry, Hibbleman, too. How do you do?
How do you do, Mr. Orchestra? How do you do, Mrs. Mezzanine? How'd you do, Lord and Lady Balcony? You're the welcomest sight we've ever seen. We say it again, encore. You've never seen us before, but we hope before this evening ends, cast registers hope
that new faces and you will be good friends.
Here today to celebrate our good friend Mel Brooks. And if you know the score to The Producers well, the stage show, there's a number that starts the show opening night, right? It's Max Bialystock's opening night. It's the same tune as New Faces of 1952. Who knew? I knew. That's why you tune into Broadway to Main Street. Well, in 1962, Mel, flush from his success on Your Show of Shows, wrote the book to a Strauss and Adams musical with Ray Bolger starring in it, produced by Alexander Cohen, who no doubt gave Mel some inspiration for The Producers. It was a terrible experience for Mel. A very bizarre show about a Eastern European professor who helps American football players in a call. I don't know, please. But it did yield one of the most beautiful songs, certainly from the 1960s, written by Strauss and Adams. And here is Ray Bolger and Eileen Hurley to sing that hit from All American.
Once upon a time, a girl with moonlight in her eyes put her hand in mine and said she loved me so. But that was once upon a time, very long ago. Once upon a hill, we sat beneath a willow tree, counting all the stars and waiting for the dawn. But that was once upon a time. Now the tree is gone. How the breeze ruffled through her hair, how we always laughed as though tomorrow wasn't there. We were young and didn't have a care. Where did it go? Once upon a time, the world was sweeter than we knew. Everything was ours. How happy we were then. But somehow, once upon a time, never comes again.
Once upon a time, it seemed the world was painted gold, and there was a man, and oh, I loved him. Silver stars like necklaces were strewn. nothing to conceal. Every little thought was so exciting to reveal. All our dreams we knew would soon be real.
Lovely tender ballad. And that, folks, is the last lovely tender thing you're going to hear for the rest of the hour, because now we're going to go into full throttle crazy wacky Mel. As I'm sure you know, he and Carl Reiner recorded hours and hours of what is easily among, if not the greatest improv act of all time, the 2,000-year-old man. And here Carl Reiner asked the 2,000-year-old man to talk a little bit about music, and boy does he ever.
Sir, you've heard music develop from the primitive drums to today.
Absolutely.
Do you like music?
I listen to it. I love music, all music except the French.
What's wrong with it?
It's very repetitive.
Repetitive?
Very repetitive.
But they had some great composers.
Nah, that's repetitive. Every French
thing. What about Bizet?
Dun, 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 dun.
No, but that Ravel.
The worst.
All right. What about Jacques Brel?
Please don't go away. If you'll go away, then I'll have to stray with a guy that's gay. In a French cafe, you'll go away, and you'll ruin my day, and you'll stay away, and I'll have to pay for the guy that's there in the French cafe. It never stops. Goes around in ever descending circles. If you'll leave me there, don't leave me there, or I'll drink a beer, and you'll have a Kia with Norman Lear, and I'm sitting here. With my lousy beer.
I see.
And you'll go away.
I'm beginning to agree.
And you'll stay away. And you'll be away. And I'll have to stay.
I'm beginning to
agree. And I'll have to stay. And you'll be away. And Norman Lear, drinking beer. You'll be away.
Yes.
No, I don't get it.
I'm beginning to get your
point. I don't get the whole French music.
The power of a sweet flower is gonna rule the earth, and there'll be a great rebirth. Love is the flower that is mine when I'm walking with my darling, and we're holding hands, and life is fine, 'cause she understands. Walking down the sunny street, giving pretty flowers to the people that we meet. And I give a flower to the big fat cop. He takes his club and he beats me up. I give a flower to the garbage man. He stuffs my girl in the garbage. It down. It goes into the sewer with the earth running through her, and it runs into the river that we drink. Hey, where you stink? Man, it's later than you think. Where you got just one more chance? Come on, baby, while I dance. talking about love power, the power of a little flower. You don't think about no little flowers. Oh no, all you think about is guns. If everybody in the world today had a flower instead of a gun, there would be no wars. There would be one big smell in. Just a flower. To my flower, hurt it like everything else. Like everything else, your flower.
And I'm sure you'll all join me in saying, "That's our Hitler." That is from the film of the producers, which was Mel Brooks, of course, first big. Directorial writing achievement. He won an Academy Award for Best Screenplay. And that song, sung by Dick Shawn, music and lyrics by Mel Brooks, was not in the show. So we'll talk about that later. But I just love that performance. We all like that performance if we've seen that movie by the hilarious Dick Shawn. Well, Mel Brooks really hit his stride in the mid-1970s with Blazing Saddles and Young Frankenstein, High Anxiety. Here is the title number to Blazing Saddles, the song that put him on the commercial map, and we have to doff our Stetson to John Morris, who left us a couple months ago, who was Mel's great musical collaborator throughout so much of his film career. But get your whips out and take it away, Frankie Lane.
Blazing saddle, he wore a shining star. His job to offer battle to bad men near and far. He conquered fear and he conquered hate. He turned dark night into day. He made his blazing saddle a torch to light the way. Outlaws rule the west and fear filled the land. A cry went up for a man with guts to take the west in hand. They needed a man who was brave and true, with justice for all as his aim. Then out of the sun rode a man with a gun, and Bart was his name. Yes, Bart was his name. He rode a blazing saddle. He wore a shining star. His job to offer battle to bad men near and far. He conquered fear and he conquered hate. He turned dark night into day. He saddle, a torch to light the way.
Here I stand, the goddess of desire. Set men on fire. I have this power. Morning, noon, and night, it's wink and dancing. Some quick romancing. And then a shower. Stage door Johnny's constantly surround me. They always hound me with one request. Who can satisfy their lustful habit? I'm not a rabbit. I need some rest. I'm tired, sick, and tired of love. I've had my fill of love from below and above. Tired of being admired, tired of love uninspired. Let's face it, I'm tired. I've been with thousands of men again and again. They promise the moon. They're always coming and going and coming, and always too soon. Vipers, I'm tired, tired of playing the game. Ain't it a crying shame? I'm so tired. God damn it, I'm exhausted. Hello, cowboy. What's your name?
Tex, ma'am.
Tex, ma'am. Tell me, Tex, ma'am, are you in show business?
Nope.
Well, then why don't you get your friggin' feet up? Hello, handsome. Is that a 10-gallon hat, or are you just enjoying the show?
Put it there, baby, put it down.
I'm tired of playing the game. Ain't it a crying shame? I'm so tired.
She's tired.
She's tired.
Sick and tired of love.
Give her the break.
She's had a fill of love.
She's not a snake.
From below and above.
Can't you see she's sick?
Tired.
She's bush.
Tired of being admired.
Let her alone.
Tired of love uninspired.
Get off your phone.
She's tired.
Don't you know she's pooped?
I've been with thousands of men. Everything below the waist is kaput.
The brilliant, lovely genius of Madeline Kahn. Mel Brooks, you heard in the back going, can't you see she's pooped? Good old Mel. Well, he wrote so many good songs for his movies, and normally I would play his highlight, which I think is High Anxiety, but I think even Mel would have to agree that the silver-throated Harry Connick Jr. might be a better candidate.
Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Connick Jr.
High Anxiety. Whenever you're near, high anxiety, it's you that I fear. It's very clear to me, I've got to give in. High anxiety, whenever you're near, high anxiety, it's you that I fear. It's very clear to me I've got to give in. Anxiety. Could someone get me down from here, please? You win.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Kine.
Inquisition. Let's begin the Inquisition. Look out, Sid, we have a mission to convert the Jews. Convert, don't be boring. Say yes, don't be dull. A fact you're ignoring. It's better to lose your skull cap than your skull. All right, the ball. Inquisition.
What a show.
The Inquisition.
Here we go.
We know you're wishing that we'd go away. 'Cause the Inquisition's here. And it's here to stay. Look out, Torquemada is back.
From the Kennedy Center Honors, which honored, of course, Mel Brooks. Well, Broadway was always that great, wonderful dream out there for Mel, and his wish came true in 2001 when he had his arm twisted, I guess, gently by various people, including Mike Ockrent and Susan Stroman and a bunch of producers, to bring the producers on stage, and it became one of the biggest hits ever. I still think it's the winner for most Tony Awards won by a single production. Took the world by storm. Here is a little bit of a, I don't know, bonus track. Here is The King of Broadway, which Mel became after that, but it is the film soundtrack version with Nathan Lane that was actually cut from the movie. So the song is pretty similar to the Broadway one, but, you know, just for the heck of it, here's a different rendition, and if you have kids in the room, you might want to put your hands over their ears here and there. Caveat emptor, you are warned. But here is Nathan, cut, unbelievably cut, from the film of the producers.
You're looking at the man who used to be the king. The king of all Broadway, the best of everything, was mine to have each day. I always had the biggest hits, the biggest bathrooms at the Ritz. My showgirls had the biggest hits, I never was the pits in any way.
We believe you, thousands for that. We believe you, every word. We believe.
I used to be the king.
The king!
The king of all Broadway. My praises they would sing. A Ziegfeld, so they'd say. My shows were always filled with class. The best champagnes would fill my glass. My lap was filled with gorgeous ass. You couldn't call me crass in any way.
We believe you,
there was a time when I was young and gay, but straight. There was a time when I was bold. There was a time when each and every play I touched would turn to gold.
There was a time in Broadway's doors.
I think
his shoes were always worn.
Now I wear a rented tux that's 2 weeks overdue.
For me, Abby, what's the shoe
rent? Such reviews. How dare
dare they insult me in this manner? How quickly they forget I was a protege of the great Boris Tomaszewski. Yes, yes, I know. He taught me everything I know. I'll never forget he turned to me on his deathbed and said, Maxilla, alle Menschen müssen machen. Hey, du ganzen Kaschen, Bischen, Pippi, Krachen.
What does that mean?
Who knows? I don't speak Yiddish. Strangely enough, neither did he. But in my heart, I knew what he was saying. He was saying when you're down and out and everybody thinks you're finished, that's the time to stand up on your two feet and shout, who do you have to fuck to get a break in this stinking town? Nights again, you'll see my name and lights again. I'll go from dark to bright again. My spirit's high as kites again. I'll never suffer slights again. I'll taste those sweet delights again. No plethora of flights again. No blossoming of blights again. No frantic fits or frights again. Fame is in my sights again. I'll take those fancy flights again. I'm gonna scale the heights again. The other stock will never drop. The other stock will never stop. The other stock will be on top again. I'll be on top again.
Have you ever heard a Mel Brooks song? With the bing and the bang and the all offensive slang. Have you ever heard a Mel Brooks song? With the guilt and the fault and the Jewish Eugewalt. Stephen Sondheim is wordy and too bloody. It don't mean a thing if it doesn't insult everybody. Have you ever heard a Mel Brooks song? With the slur and the slap and the sting. Mel Brooks lyrics insult you in a flawed way. The only guy who's sicker is that dummy, crummy, stupid guy who writes Forbidden Broadway. Shoot him! Big Kid Chat. Have you ever heard a Mel Brooks song with a trend to offend everyone? It's the only kind of insults that will leave you applauding when it's done. Hit with Hitler.
And a hit from Forbidden Broadway. What a great challenge that is to parody a great parodist, but they did. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, and today we're looking at the King of Broadway. It's good to be the King, Mel Brooks. I just came back from London where I saw a revised version of Young Frankenstein, his next big Broadway musical, which I rather liked in its Broadway incarnation, and it's been sort of trimmed and nipped and tucked and sewn together just like that giant creature with the Schwanstucker, and I think it's great. Here are three wonderful songs, I think, from the score to Young Frankenstein, leading off with Roger Bart and Chris Fitzgerald.
Oh, the fantastic things we'll do. It will be like old times, you and me. Right up there with the world's greatest pairs. Like Laurel and Hardy, like Coke and Bacardi, like Juliet and Romeo, ebb and flow, to and fro, together, together again. Together again for the first time. We've only met in a dream. Up until now, it's been the worst time. But now that you're here, we're a team. Together again for the first time. Haven't a woe or a care. No longer a bad and a cursed time. It's easy to see, you have to agree. We're destined to be a great pair.
my life I've been stoogin' around. Nothing to do at a loss. All of my life I've been stoogin' around. But what good is a stooge if he ain't got a boss? Together again for the first time, back on the track to renown. We're gonna thrill 'em, we're gonna kill 'em. You'll be the teacher, we'll make a new creature and scare the bloomin' daylights right out of this town.
Stop it, stop, you don't understand. I'll only be here for a few days to settle my grandfather's estate. And then I am heading straight back to New York. No laboratories, no creatures.
Bet you change your mind, Master. Come on, join in a chorus, it's fun!
My dear Igor, I happen to be the Dean of Anatomy at a world-renowned school of medicine. Although I do sing a bit. And was, in fact, a whiffin' poof at Yale.
A whiffin' poof! Wow! Come on, Doc, nobody's around!
Well, nobody is around. What the hell?!
Together again for the first time. Having to woe or a care. No longer a bad and a great.
This is the best time. It's easy to see. You have to agree. We're destined to be a great pair.
May I
take it?
All of my life I've been bossing around. Mean and alone like a Scrooge. All of my life I've been bossing around. But what good is a boss if he ain't got a stooge? I'm sorry. Well, I don't wish to embarrass you, but I am a rather brilliant surgeon. Perhaps I can help you with that hump.
What hump?
Together again for the first time. We've only met in a dream.
Like Ginger and Freddy, McDonald and Eddie.
Like Salmon and Teddy.
Or meatballs and spaghetti. But the pair that we cry for, the pair that we sigh for, the pair that we die for. Walk this way. No, this way, like this. Really?
Huh?
Yeah, really drag your foot, your left foot.
Drag my foot?
Yeah.
All right.
You get creepy, you know? Get creepy.
Wait.
Together again for the first time. We've only met in a dream.
Like Emil and Macy. Like Hepburn and Tracy.
Like Lamont and Gable.
Like good old Cain and Abel.
For the first time. Together again. Together forever again.
How are we getting to the castle?
A wee strop fair de schlagen wagen suchen fruchen.
What's that?
A hayride.
Roll in the hay, roll, roll your troubles away. When life is awful, just jump on a stroffle and roll. Roll in the hay, roll, roll, roll in the hay, roll, roll, do it all day. When spirits are sagging, just jump in a wagon and roll, roll in the hay. I'm very high-spirited, Doctor. I hope you won't hold it against me.
Oh, I'll try not to.
Hitch those horses up for a gay ride. We'll have lots of fun. Nothing's better than a hayride underneath the sun.
Roll, roll, roll in the hay.
Sometimes love finds a bay. You might steal a kiss from an unwitting miss who's not too resistant to play. So let's roll, roll, roll.
Have you thought of any ways you could use me?
Two, and I'm working on a third.
Oh, good. Does that mean I'm hired?
Well, a large part of me is pointing in that direction.
Roll, roll in the hay.
We'll go up the path, then down the hill. Back up the path, then down the hill. We'll go up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down.
Hitch those horses up for a gay ride.
Your lady,
rolling.
rollin' it,
rollin' it, yodelady, yodelady,
rollin' it,
rollin' it, come take a hayride, take your breath away, ride, rollin' it, rollin' the hay. Yodelady, 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 lady, 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 yodelady, 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 yodelady.
What's that?
Werewolves.
Werewolves?
They're wolves!
What?
They're wolves! They're castle!
Why are you talking like that?
I don't know! I don't know. I don't know.
I thought you wanted me to.
Well, I don't.
Have it your way. I'm easy.
Young lady, oh dee dee. Young lady, oh dee dee.
So let's roll, roll, roll. We'll all roll, roll, roll.
Come with me and roll.
Rollin', rollin',
rollin', rollin', rollin', rollin' the hay. If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits?
Margaret!
Different types who wear a day coat, pants with stripes and cutaway coat, perfect fits.
Margaret!
Dressed up like a $1 million trooper, trying hard to look like Gary Cooper. Come, let's mix with Rockefellers, walk with sticks or umbrellas in their midst.
Margaret!
Have you seen Zavelle to do up and down Park Avenue?
On that famous thoroughfare, with their noses in the air.
High hats and arrow collars, white spats and lots of dollars.
Spending every dime for a wonderful time.
If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where the fashion sits?
Put, putting on the Ritz.
Different types who wear a day coat, prints with stripes and cutaway coats, the perfect fits.
Cha 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 cha, putting on the Ritz. Take it.
Bop da ba 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 da ba da ba da 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 da.
Let's mix the Rockefellers, walk with sticks or umbrellas in their midst.
You know, every time I hear that song, my heart breaks just a little bit for the Irving Berlin estate, because will you ever be able to hear that song again without thinking, well, the price of fame, right? As I mentioned earlier, Young Frankenstein is doing Gangbusters over on the West End. Perhaps we'll see a sort of scaled down version of that replayed on Broadway. I think where it belongs. Well, Mel Brooks clearly belonged on Broadway. It was his childhood dream to appear on The Great White Way, and all of his movies are suffused with such loving and hilarious takes on the Broadway and Hollywood canon, so I think it was only a sort of divine matter of time where he would transform his deep affection for a Broadway to an actual big Broadway hit and a follow-up show, less of a hit, but now a big hit on the West End. And at 92, I assume that Mel Brooks will keep going strong and keep churning stuff out. He sort of threatens to do a Blazing Saddles musical. Might be tough, all those horses. But he's still very much with us and circulating around the country. He does one-night events where he screens films and probably sings a song or two, a little song and dance, and makes people laugh. So I hope you enjoyed this hour of Mel on Broadway to Main Street. He certainly brought an extraordinary number of hours, many more hours than I could possibly count, to me growing up. I remember seeing the producers when I was a wee lad, and it's made me laugh ever since. And if you're enjoying Broadway to Main Street, I hope you'll go on to our new website, broadwaytomainstreet.libsyn, or listen to us on iTunes, because there, as they say, plenty more where that comes from. Here is the, what would I say, the real entree of the Mel Brooks buffet, the Viennese table at the Bar Mitzvah, which is, of course, Springtime for Hitler, so beautifully expanded and rendered in the stage version of the musical, particularly with a performance by Gary Beach, genius beyond genius, as Roger Debris slash Adolf Hitler. So take it away, Mel. I assume we thought this episode would close on page 4, but it didn't. It's a great episode, and I hope you enjoyed it.
Out, here comes the master race. Springtime for Hitler and Germany. Rhineland's a fine land once more. Springtime for Hitler and Germany. Watch out, Europe, we're going on tour. Springtime for Hitler and Germany.
Look, it's springtime.
Winter for Poland and France.
Springtime for Hitler and Germany.
Germans, go into your dance.
I was born in Dusseldorf, and that is why they call me Rolf. Don't be stupid, be a smarty. Come and join the Nazi party.
Change our history. I'll myself raise your hand. There's no greater dictator in the land. Everything I do for you. If you're looking for a war, here's World War II. I'll myself raise your beer. Every Hotsy Totsy Nazi stand and cheer.
Hooray! Every Hotsy Totsy Nazi.
I'll myself.
Told me I was Führer. Germany was blue. Oh, what a what to do. Hitched up my pants and conquered France. Now Deutschland's smiling through.
But it wasn't always so easy. It was 1932. Hindenburg was working the big room, and I was playing the lounge. And then I got my big break. Somebody burned down the Reichstag, and would you believe it? They made me chancellor. Chancellor!
It ain't no mystery if it's politics or history. The thing you gotta know is everything is showbiz. My show. I'm the German Ethel Merman, don't you know? We are crossing borders. The New World Order is here. Make a great big smile. Everyone sing heil to me. Wonderful me.
Bombs falling from the sky.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.